And so one of the biggest wins that I've had is we had a patient who had spirochetes, who again was perfectly, well, he was sent to me by a periodontist, said, the periodontist said he was fine. He was ready to have an implant. And this is a case that I shared on Hygiene Hackers. Ready for an implant, took his biofilm, had spirochetes. So I delayed taking the implant and told him to start using the BioShore, the ozone rinse. And 2 months later, he came back saying, yeah, let's check this. Let's see what it's like. And I was shocked. I couldn't believe it looked like a completely different person in terms of the biofilm. Like nothing was moving. You know, there was just basically, you know, some small rods and cocci and nothing else, no spirochetes whatsoever. So that was amazing. And I think possibly, you know, if you're not using ozone, I think you're just, yeah, it's just behind the ball. But the other thing that I thought was really quite, and I only just started using GBT and the EMS about 3-4 weeks now, but that combination of disclosing and showing the patient where it is, and then not only that, but I sometimes take the dark blue stained biofilm and put it under the microscope and look at that, and you can see exactly what that is, and you can see the problem there, and that really hits home for them. They just get it. They just understand, and we have no resistance. When Natasha says, "Oh, we need to see you in a month. We need to see you then in 3 months after that, and we'll test it again." There's no resistance. It's just like, "Yep, okay, let's do it."